Hello fans and friends, welcome to another video. My name's Keir Smith. For today's video, I'm going to take you through my experience of Glastonbury 2023. Myself and two friends went down on Wednesday the 21st of June. The festival didn't start properly until Friday the 23rd, and we got back a week last Monday, the 26th of June. So we were there for 5 days and we saw a lot of great acts, a lot of great music, and I'll share with you now some of the footage that I took while I was there. As I said, the festival doesn't start until the Friday and we got down there on the Wednesday, but there's always plenty to do and plenty to see in the lead up to the festival. There's a big cinema tent at Glastonbury and that shows various films throughout the festival if you want to get away from the music for a short while and watch a film. And on the Thursday night before the festival started, me and my mate Chris went to this cinema tent to watch a documentary about a band we'd never heard of before. And this documentary had been put together and filmed by the comedian Stuart Lee about a guy called Robert Lloyd, the lead singer of the band The Nightingales, who were around in the 80s. And it followed the life and times of this Robert Lloyd guy and his band The Nightingales. And he was always on the cusp of greatness, nearly made it, but never quite did. But it was a really interesting and funny documentary. Robert Lloyd is not what you'd call a typical songsmith. His band came out of the punk movement in the 70s, and from what I heard of his music in the film, I'm not sure whether I'll like it or dislike it, but I'll give it a go. So that was Robert Lloyd and the Nightingales, but now onto the festival, which for me started at 1:15 on the Friday on the Pyramid stage with Maisie Peters. Maisie Peters is a girl I'd never heard of, but my friend Mark seemed keen to go down and see her, so we did. And this was kind of girl pop rock stuff. It reminded me of some of those early Taylor Swift songs. So here's some footage of Maisie Peters singing a song from the album she was promoting called The Good Witch. I'm on a one-way trip, take away the book, she was good. I really liked her. Lots of pop hooks and melodies, which I'm always a fan of. And from there, I then went to watch the Lightning Seeds, who were performing on a stage called The Other Stage at 2:00. So I missed the start of that, but they were an indie pop rock band from the 90s who I quite liked. So here's some footage of the Lightning Seeds playing one of their hits from the 90s called Marvelous. And here's another one that I really liked called Lucky You. And their final song was, as Ian Brody called it, now their slogan song. Here's a chorus of Three Lions. Then at 6:00 in the evening at the Woodsies tent, which was right outside our campsite, was a band I really like, the Cortinas. Now I only caught 20 minutes of their set, but they rattled through 5 songs from their excellent debut album, St. Jude. Here's Cavorting.
Cautious, to the
great song called Fallowfield Hillbilly. So I only saw 20 minutes of the Cortinas because I had to make my way to the Pyramid stage, which was only 5 minutes away, to see the mystery act, the Churn-Ups, who were starting at 6:15. And this mystery act, the Churn-Ups, of course, turned out to be the Foo Fighters, which by the time they came on stage was common knowledge. And I was excited to see the Foo Fighters because I'm a fan and I'd never seen them before, but I could not get near the stage. So here's some footage of the Foo Fighters, albeit on the big screen, rattling their way through their song, The Pretender. Who are you? Yeah, who are you? Later on, playing the brilliant Everlong. Look at that crowd. And from there, I then made my way to the acoustic stage, which through the crowd took me about 20 minutes. And I went there to meet my mate Chris to watch an American singer-songwriter called Steve Earle. I stumbled across Steve Earle 3 or 4 years ago. I heard a few songs I liked, so I bought an album by him called Guitar Town, which was one of his albums in the mid-80s. And this is good country rock. I like it. So here's a bit of Steve Earle singing a politically charged song called It's About Blood.
Snipper was an accident, isolated incident, part of the job. Yeah, tell that to the families, kids of that, that is intended to die.
And then from there, as the big crowd went to watch the main act on the Pyramid stage, the Arctic Monkeys, I took the longest walk, jog, run, all the way over to the park, which was the other side of Worthy Farm, to watch Sparks. Now, I must say, this is all down to Larry Graves and his excellent YouTube channel, The Canadian Stud Muffin. And he's a huge Sparks fan, and he's done so many videos about Sparks. And having watched them, it's hard not to pick up on someone's enthusiasm for a band that they love so much. And pre-Glastonbury, I watched one of his videos where he re-ranked the Sparks albums from his least favourite to favourite. And if I remember right, this album was in his top 10, so I bought my first Sparks album, Exotic Creatures of the Deep. And I really liked that album. I played it 3 or 4 times in the lead up to Glastonbury, so by the time I got to Glastonbury, I was really excited to see Sparks. And they didn't disappoint. I thought they were very entertaining. And here's some footage of them running through a song called Balls. I don't know Sparks' back catalogue at all, but here's a really good song, and I've since found out that it's one of their more popular songs called When Do I Get to Sing My Way? What song I know?
One offer that I could refuse.
great. Russell Mayle, the lead singer, was hopping and skipping around the stage like a young spring chicken. And his brother Ron, who is well known for sitting at the keys, stiff as a board, although he did get up to deliver a spoken word piece on one song. And then later on, he got up again to do this rather gangly, wonky dance across the stage, which was rather amusing. So that was Friday. Saturday started relatively early, 11:15 at the Woodsy's tent for a group I'd never heard of called The Last Dinner Party. And this was five girls up front, all singing and playing instruments, a guy at the back on drums, and the lead singer was swirling around the stage like a young Stevie Nicks. And they delivered a really intense performance, very deep lyrically. It was interesting, good. So here's a bit of footage of them. And then mid-afternoon, me and Mark went to watch a band again who I'd never heard of at the BBC introducing stage called Vleur. Now, Chris had sold this band to us as a band of angry Scottish men. They were kind of dance, heavy electronica. See what you think. Then at 5 o'clock Saturday evening, I again made my way over to the acoustic stage to see Richard Thompson of Fairport Convention fame. Here's him singing a lovely song called I Misunderstood. On to Saturday night, and this was my night, starting at the other stage at 6:45 for Manic Street Preachers. As I was waiting for the Manics to come on stage, they were playing some really cool tunes. This one, a kind of dub version of David Bowie's Space Oddity. Roxy Music's Love Is The Drug, which is such a cool tune. I'm a huge Manic Street Preachers fan. I've seen them 6 or 7 times through the years, and they played a couple of songs here at Glastonbury from my favourite album by them, The Holy Bible. Here's Die in the Summertime. And here's a huge favourite of mine, an extended piece for you. This is Faster.
Yeah.
They were brilliant. Just under an hour for their set. All killer, no filler. Motorcycle emptiness, everything must go. A design for life. They finished with, if you tolerate this, your children will be next. I loved it. And then for the main headline act, which I was super excited about, at the Pyramid stage, Guns N' Roses. Guns N' Roses could well be the first band that I got into in my teenage years. My brothers would play their CDs and I'd be listening with them, and I loved it. And the set list was amazing. Mr. Brownstone, Night Train, Paradise City, Sweet Child of Mine, Estranged, November Rain, among many others, but Axl Rose was a little disappointing, I have to say. And a lot has been said about the band's performance since, but I simply think that Axl Rose is, what, 60 years old? These are big stadium rock songs, and I don't think his voice could quite cut it. It sounded great on some songs, and then on others, it was really letting the side down. But here's some footage of the band singing It's So Easy. And welcome to the jungle. Footage of Slash ripping his way through one of the many great solos that he performed that night. He was fantastic. And the solo for November Rain, one of my favourite songs of all time. So that was Saturday night, now on to Sunday, the final day. Me, Chris and Mark all went down to see this band called Black Country New Road, which Chris was really excited about. And they were interesting, very rich instrumentation, very well played, but it was very slow and I was rather bored by it, if I'm honest. They drew a fair crowd, and at the end of the gig, a lad who I was introduced to came away saying how emotional he felt and that it was one of the most wonderful things he'd seen. But me and Mark were clearly not in the mood because we looked at each other and both agreed that it was pretty dull. We'd met up with some friends at that gig, and from there me and my friend Tom went and sat up on the hill overlooking the Pyramid stage and watched Cat Stevens. And that was nice, and as a big Beatles fan, I got a nice surprise when he played this. Here comes the sun, nice day, it's alright. He played three or four new songs which I didn't know, and of course he played his big songs like Wild World and Father and Son. On to the main headline act, Sunday evening, 9 o'clock. The Pyramid stage, Sir Elton John. Now, I began to tire at this point, so early Sunday evening I went for a little snooze in my tent. But I got up late and it was around about 9:15, so I got my stuff together and I ran down to the Pyramid stage for about 8:50. The early bird catches the worm. If you want to see the the main headline act at Glastonbury, I suggest you get to the stage 1, even 2 hours before to secure a good spot. But I was late, so again, I couldn't get near the stage. But here's some Elton John for you, singing Benny and the Jets. And here's one of my top five Elton songs, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. And as you will have seen, Elton made a really touching tribute to his friend, the late great George Michael, just before he sang Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me. And of course, Elton played a great set. How could he not? He's got all the hits. I guess that's why they call it the blues, sad songs, I'm Still Standing, which is my favourite Elton John song, and the grand finale, Rocket Man. And that capped off a really good festival. I'm really pleased to say that I've seen Elton John. So that was Glastonbury 2023. My main highlights were Manic Street Preachers and Sparks. And of course, Glastonbury is synonymous with flag wavers everywhere. And after seeing so many, I decided to take a photo of one and crown it my favourite flag of Glastonbury 2023. Send nudes. And I almost did. And loads of people were wearing bucket hats. Here's my favourite. Best T-shirt award goes to yours truly. This is me wearing my Ian Brown T-shirt, which I got 8 or 9 compliments for. So we're now looking forward to Glastonbury 2024. My hopes for the headline acts would be Taylor Swift and the 1975, but we'll have to wait and see. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give it the thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to the channel, but only if you want to. See you next time.